question me, you know what it is. Ain't think of me, I did it all for you. You see the scars, I had to pay my due. I gave my heart and you still switched on me. Stab me in my back and then you watched me bleed. Switched on me, switched on me. Oh, 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 oh. I know I'm God sent. Hoping I could bring my brothers all up to heaven.
Spoken thought. Today's segment is the badge of honor. It's the badge of honor that God's children carry. You gotta understand God's children. He has a son and a daughter. Mostly society has talked about his son, the descending angel. Man. Okay. They don't even know what's greater than a man, because God would have never accept man back in heaven. But today's segment is not about that. It's about his daughter and what his daughter promised to do for her father. And understanding the badges that she carries in heaven is greater than any badge that a man can carry on his own chest. Understand that. That's the true badge of honor. And understand that starting as a descending goddess of God's daughter, goddess, guess what? That right there, that's powerful. And what did she promise her father? To do labor for him. That labor is more important than any labor she can do for any man on earth. She's doing celestial labor before a man even becomes a father. She is already a mother 10 months before he becomes a father. God will spend 10 months inside of his daughter to make sure she has all that she needs to be able to take care of his child on earth and take care of herself. He will make sure she's protected. He'll make sure that she's provided for. And she'll make sure that she has somebody there to help parent his child, any of his children, not just the seed of that man's child. Any offspring of God's is our child. And we have to see it as that. Even if we don't find a value for our own children, the greater value is the value of child, how God sees it. Don't even see his daughter as a woman. And God has given her everything she needs to get the three P's from you, to parent his offspring, to provide for her. Don't let society say, hey, she got to become your wife and sign a piece of paper. You don't even got to take that piece of paper to heaven. If you want to go through heaven on earth, and God has given her that, the fruit of a goddess, heaven on earth is between the legs of a goddess. You better respect it as that, because the forbidden fruit is not allowed in heaven. That's a man. A man is not allowed in heaven, nor a woman. And if you accept a man, any woman accepts a man and commits to a man, that's the forbidden fruit. The child won't be nothing wrong with the child, but your relationship with that man will be fucked up. That is the taste of a forbidden fruit. You will not be able to have good relationships with a man. Only a gentleman, because the gentleman submits to the oath of God. And the oath of God as the son of God, the angel, he will provide, and protect. Simple. You can break it down on whatever level, but within there, that providing is provision for it. Understand that. COD, cash on delivery, no, credit on demand. You have that credit. And it's the demand given to you by God. You done labor, special. And if he went to heaven, even if he did not do labor for that particular man, if he went to heaven, you better hope he went as a gentleman. And then the stuff I'm saying is easy for him to understand. You don't have to give, you don't have to take a seed and make it into a child. Even if he tried to plant it and God didn't choose it, and God is the one. It's simple. I don't know if God is a man or a woman, but I know this. He takes the seed of a man, an egg of a woman. He bonds it together with his spirit. I am speaking to the spirit in you. Your soul is nothing but a roller coaster ride. Your soul can be a tree, a dolphin, a cat, a shark, It's wherever Jesus sees fit that he needs on earth if he runs company earth. If there is a Jesus in your religion, and God has his son, and the chain of command says, follow the chain of command, you better respect Jesus before you ask God. Just think about it. If not, hey, still safe. I believe there's something greater than man. That is God and his son, the chain of command. God says, do this, do on the earth as he would do in the heaven. It's so simple. If you bow down to God because he gives you life, your celestial life, your forever life, the son of God and the daughter of God, therefore ever life is the goddess and the angel within them. They will come back to earth in many different forms and whatever other solar system and planet there may be. They've got so many different badges. The badges of a lady, a goddess, is a lady on earth, a mother to God's child, a goddess, daughter's God's daughter, a goddess. That's the name of God's daughter. She is a goddess to God. And I see her as God. Can I stand a woman? That's part of her stages on earth. And that's a strong, difficult time. I understand her. I'm not gonna fight her. Don't have no need to fight the woman. Just understand it and step aside. If you ain't enough man for her, if she feel I ain't enough man, I have to respect that. And I do. I do. But hey, what else can I say? That's why I would choose and wait for a lady to find me worthy of her mentally, emotionally, and then she choose to reward me on a physical level. That's the order. I am here to serve a goddess, not the woman. No need for me to serve a woman. She has man enough in her. She has to believe in that man in her before she'll let go of that man in her. If she doesn't believe it, she'll never find something worthy of it. She needs to know what it is that she doesn't want to carry around, and that she wants to find a creature that can handle it without her having to ask. That's what a lady does. A lady don't ask. A lady already expects that she pick out one worthy, and then she should not have to mention it to him. And the gentleman knows that. He does it without being told that, because a man don't want to be told. Understand the difference between a man and a gentleman, a woman and a lady. The recognizing the devil is not recognize the devil in the man. It's recognize the devil within you. And choosing to let go of that devil and be that angel, that goddess. An angel for a man is a gentleman on earth. A goddess to a woman is a lady on earth. The highest thing you can be on earth. Before you can reach that goddess level, that mother or father level, a boy can be a father. A girl can be a mother. You still gonna have to act the behaviors of a lady and a mother. They are so similar. Respect them. The things a woman would do, a lady would never, and a mother can't. The things a man would do, a gentleman knows not to, and a father can't, because he's the father to God's child. As simple as that. Understand that. Take the time to think about it. Your self-guidance. The things you think, God knows. The things you sense, God knows, and Jesus. That is your telltale. And speak the truth in that, what you sense and what you feel and think. If you ain't for sure, just ask. What would Jesus do? And if you're going to bow down to God because he gives you life in heaven, only Boo Boo the Fool would not bow down to a goddess that brings life on earth. That is a female goddess, a lady, a mother. The woman is just part of her trials and tribulations. Don't fall her. Don't fight her. Understand her. Understand a woman. Ain't nothing wrong with a man or a woman. They just misunderstood. And we're not right for each other in that stage for one another. We're not even right for ourselves. We're trying to figure out whatever type of man I'm going to be, whatever type of man I can be. And at the end of the day, I'm going to choose from that man I have been and all the different men I have been and try to make the best gentleman I can be. But you have to choose the gentleman in me. Don't settle for the man in me. Don't. It's many versions of me. I've been a good man, but I know the bad parts of it too.